Sonora, Mexico, whose boyish demeanor belies a prodigious talent.
Until Election Day. No time to lose in a presidential race where every vote counts. Nora O'Donnell is on the campaign trail with candidate Kamala Harris.
I'm not here as a celebrity. I'm not here as a politician. I'm here as a mother.
Beyoncé's song, Freedom, has become Kamala Harris's anthem. And that was the message in Houston Friday night.
So why Texas? You know, Texas is ground zero on this most extraordinary issue, which is that we are fighting for a woman's right to make decisions about our own body.
Tonight, Beyonce's second opening act.
I know, I'm really excited about that.
It was the vice president's largest rally ever. 30,000 people bring to 90-degree heat.
And now the Attorney General of Texas is suing the United States government.
To hear her scorching new attack on Texas's strict abortion rules.
On the one hand, Donald Trump won't let anyone see his medical records. And on the other hand, they want to get their hands on your medical records. Simply put, they are out of their minds.
We traveled with the vice president over 2 days for a rare behind-the-scenes look on Air Force Two and the battleground state of Michigan.
I gotta ask myself, why on earth is this race even close? I lay awake at night wondering what in the world is going on.
Where Michelle Obama campaigned with Kamala Harris for the first time, challenging men to see women's health care as a life or death matter.
If we don't get this election right, your wife, your daughter, your mother, we as women will become collateral damage to your rage.
I pledge to you, when Congress passes a bill to restore reproductive freedom nationwide, as President of the United States, I will proudly sign it.
You have been clear that that is a priority, but what you have not been clear on is what that bill would look like. You talked about restoring rural
states. Very clear.
If you have not said what restrictions you would support.
Let's put back in place Roe versus Wade. This was not an issue. When Roe versus Wade was intact for 50 years, half a century, women, together with their physicians, were here in the medical office talking with physicians. And women, in consultation, if they chose, with their priest, their pastor, their rabbi, their imam.
So you were able to support restrictions after viability.
I support Roe versus Wade being put back into law by Congress and to restore the fundamental right of women to make decisions about their own body. It is that basic.
But you know, there are restrictions. With Roe versus Wade, there were restrictions after viability.
We would not be debating this if Donald Trump had not hand-selected 3 members of the United States Supreme Court with the intention they would undo the protections of Roe v. Wade. And what we have seen, as demonstrated last night and every day these last 2 years, is extraordinary harm that has occurred in America, where women have died because of Trump abortion bans, where women who have survived rape and girls' incest, and no exception for someone whose body has been violated to make a decision about what happens to their body next. We have seen women who are experiencing a miscarriage around a pregnancy they prayed for and being denied health care because doctors are afraid they're going to go to prison, and those women developing sepsis. We have seen extraordinary harm and pain and suffering happen because of what Donald Trump did in intending and effectuating an overturning of Roe v. Wade. Yes, my first priority is to put back in place those protections and to stop this pain and to stop this injustice that is happening around our country.
So then why not say what we're looking
for as part of what I told you to put back in place Roe v. Wade? And when you argue that Donald Trump, if elected, would put forward a national abortion ban.
Just read Project 2020.
The former president said that's not true.
He says everything.
Come on, are we really taking his word for it? He said that women should be punished. He has been all over the place on this. But I'm too busy watching what he's doing to see what he has said.
Harris is on the trail in Pennsylvania today, and she plans to make a major address this coming Tuesday.
1 week before Election Day, we will be in Washington, not in a battleground state, to give a major speech at the same place that Donald Trump did on January 6th. Why?
So I would, and do think about that place, more in the context of what will be behind me, which is the White House. And I'm doing it there because I think it's very important for the American people to see and think about who will be occupying that space on January 20th. And the reality of it is that most Americans can visualize the Oval Office. We've seen it on television. And this is a real scenario. It's either going to be Donald Trump or it's going to be me, sitting behind the Resolute desk in the Oval Office.
With 9 days left to go, the vice president tells us there's no doubt the closing arguments will be.
His first priority is going to be people like him, not people like the people who are watching this right now, people who work hard, seniors for example, who are depending on that Social Security check as the only source of their income. When Donald Trump is saying we should raise the age of Social Security to 70 before you're eligible,
he says he's going to cut taxes on the benefits.
He has been consistent. And again, Google Project 2025 about what he thinks about Social Security and why he thinks it is nothing that should be supported, what he has, his intentions to cut Medicare and Medicare benefits, his intention, look again at Project 2025, to repeal the $35 a month cap on insulin that we have put in place.
You know that Donald Trump is disavowing Project 2025. He says that is not his campaign plan.
As you know, I'm a former prosecutor. His DNA is all over it. All over it. His running mate wrote the foreword to the book of the author of Project 2025. I believe Donald Trump's name appears at least 300 times in Project 2025. And it is a blueprint, a detailed blueprint, that is about the danger and the detail of what Donald Trump and his allies plan if he is in the White House again.
Please don't. CBS News has also asked former President Donald Trump to sit down with us to talk about this critical upcoming election. Mr. Trump has thus far declined, but the offer still stands.
DreamsResorts.com with savings of up to 40%.
Time.